shredded meat.
And we just need to get around all the other defenses.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so here we go. This is a...
type of camp is in this? High level?
It's kind of a asshole camp.
Well, actually, what I should do is take down the sniper towers. That will give me a sniper.
You're using the medulla.
Yes. Then I can take them out from...
We're so happy to be part.
Yeah. Yeah, you can often hear them celebrate the fact that they're going to be fighting. And also sometimes celebrate the fact that they're getting beat up.
Okay. So I think I actually cleared the side. Yep. Okay, so their defenses are diminished.
Take out that guy.
Yeah,
because yeah, he'll fire into the camp as well, right?
Yeah. This is out of his range,
maybe.
Fortunately, it's not out of mine. Cabin.
Okay. Now we can get into the camp. Sometimes there are like sneak ways into the camp.
Shouldn't you go get that ammo?
Do that, mate.
Who forgot to hit sniper ammo to begin with? I got killed for it.
There we go.
We've come through!
Yeah, so due to the scarcity of guns and ammo, it's really a melee-based kind of fighting game.
Yeah.
Your shotgun, the iconic Mad Max sort of shotgun, when he's not dead, he can use it as a almost like a smart bomb. Anything you point the shotgun at will go away.
Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
You left the camp.
I realize now that I didn't check the difficulty of the camp.
I think that was good.
But I still think that I could do it. Let's have a look at that. So, the area we've been moving around in so far is, well, we went with the jeeps and we went to this balloon, and we've been traveling in between these two points,
yeah,
basically. And the whole world is quite large and full of stuff.
Stock up on scrap.
A good plan. We should venture to the south, I think. My strongest hold is weak.
We'll see.
So much left of this camp now.
Well, that's what you think. So,
but if you go around, right?
Yeah, I can go around.
Okay, I think you can go into that if you just
turn off that
sneak way in there. On the right side. Just throw that.
So, as you mentioned, there's always, or almost always, a back or some sneaky way to get into the camp.
You can also usually you can also hijack or take like enemy vehicles and drive into the camps. They will let you in them, like a Trojan horse kind of thing.
Yep. Oh yeah, so we got the Fury mode going now, but unfortunately there's no more people to kill.
But tell us about the Fury mode.
Please do.
So whenever I hit people, and especially if I hit them well, I mean if I time stuff correctly, if I do a variety of stuff, I fill up my Fury meter. And when it hits the top, throw this before I continue talking. When it fills up, I unleash what's called Fury mode.
You unleash the fucking Fury.
Yes. and it's a
Swedish reference.
That was a very Swedish reference. So now I'm in Fury. My attacks are much more powerful. I have very strong finishers. For a short period of time, I am much, much buffed up. Let's use our trusty. So this is an oil transfer camp.
This is the place the kind of the convoys go to.
Yeah, this is, they store basically fuel here, and my job is basically to blow it up.
Stabby's after you.
Oops. So you see here, nasty guys with knives. I wish I had some ammo for my shot.
There we are.
Jerry can.
Little Jerry. Ow.
No. Okay. When you're in a pickle,
just climb.
So I'm actually gonna bring a friend to this fight.
Oh, that's a very, very clever idea.
Oh, he followed me. Damn it.
Of course.
These guys are
These guys are You're not...
And Stabby is with them. What you want to do is you want to stay away from the guy with the knife.
Keep on going.
Just like in real life.
Exactly.
But in your new car, life is so much easier.
Now they're coming out, and you have lured them out successfully from the camp. This is not chicken, it's being tactical. Yeah. Maybe you should,
them up a bit. Actually, this is a very good time after.
Maybe you'll have time to kill that guy. And if you can kill that guy, maybe you can get his club. And then, when you get the club, you can kill them all.
Yeah, so melee weapons are quite powerful, and unfortunately they break after a while, but until they do, they are really... Yeah, so what I was saying, this is a good time to show off the water mechanic, which refills your health.
Should have thought.
Which I could have used a while ago.
Yeah, exactly.
There we go.
You like living on the edge.
Yes. Yeah, I would show every facet of the game. So, here we go. Take two.
Then you can like 100% camps also, right?
Yeah, I mean, when I complete a camp, it will tell me that there's a lot of stuff probably that I didn't find.
So as you can see, that most of the strongholds and stuff in this part of the world are made from what kind of scrap you can find in this part of the world. It being a dried out seabed, a lot of stuff has a sort of a nautical theme to it. Being old ships and stuff that have been repurposed into
containers, shipwrecks,
yeah, stuff like that. Because everything in this world is has use. I mean, and everything that you see has once been something else. Everything was something. Ooh, one of those spike clubs. Ooh. Maybe you can find some dude to kill with it.
Oh, so much choice.
I'd rather have a jerrycan, actually.
And you can go back for the. he doesn't
for
have
one
a clue.
Guy. Okay, I like.
He doesn't
you.
Have a clue.
Yes, he actually gibbed.
Yeah.
Does.
That was a proper gibbing.
Yes.
Actually, oh.
Oh, you need a.
Fortunately, I think there was more than one.
Yes. How convenient. Except this was the club. There we go.
And after you blow that thing up, maybe you can go back to the club.
Maybe.
Well, I'm not saying you have to, but.
There we go.
Could be.
Unless there's
it's
another
just
that jerry can
I'm getting
there.
Tired.
No, no, don't.
Just seeing you die all the time. It's just like.
There we go. So, what I'm doing is I'm looking for all the transfer tanks, or like the tanks of oil and gas that I'm blowing up.
What I'm thankful about is that Max can climb with one hand also.
Yeah, that's pretty neat. So you don't have to find new jerrycans all the time.
Yeah.
Like an old man just lighting the
fire. Yes.
Perhaps, I don't know if you noticed, but there was a club laying on the ground a bit.
You don't think I can take
down down the road a piece?
This guy has a club.
Yeah.
Just take that.
Yeah, well, if you get the time before you die.
Yeah.
Killing machine. Now they're pumped up, right?
Yes, so
that's their own little fury mode,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, and that is because they have a war cry who's hanging up here banging the drums.
Oh man!
You have to kill him.
Yeah, he's fantastic. Warboys have those kinds of things. Music to egg them on.
Yes. They love their drums.
This guy.
And he's screaming all sorts of weird rallying cries to them. I think that those guys. I'm getting tired of.
What? It's a hard name.
It's just friendly banter. Now, what I was gonna say is that so perhaps they're chosen at an early age from when they're war pups, because of their ways with words and their strong voices, and then they. They're used as a sort of morale for troops.
Yeah. So when they start to bang the drums, everyone gets really psyched up. It gets harder to beat. Like you saw there. Our friend Emil getting his
ass handed to him.
Over and over.
Over and over again, yeah. Actually, what I need is.
Friendly banter.
Some jerry cans.
No.
Well, actually.
No, keep your. Oh.
You can never have too many jerry cans.
You're gonna die again.
Maybe if you just dive right into that burning jerry can.
I'm just saying you have a club there.
This is a bad fighting arena.
Yeah, exactly. Blame the arena.
This guy is.
Yeah, that's one of the tougher ones, the black ones.
As opposed to me, who's one of the untougher guys.
You really need some upgrades.
Yes,
that's for sure.
Actually, let's see if I can upgrade some stuff.
Yeah.
So obviously, I can upgrade. Both the car and Max, whenever, like out in the wasteland,
yeah.
I don't have to be in a stronghold or anything.
That's a really nice thing, so you don't have to.
It's locked. I need to
get up there.
It looks okay through there, but I keep having to try and adjust it to try and make it smoother because people are complaining that the frame rate is crap, which is why I asked you guys to talk about 30 frames.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
Okay.
There's got to be water around here somewhere.
Yeah. Exactly. We.
Ah, okay.
Sweden has really good internet. But
look at that. You picked up the club.
Yeah, let's see if I do.
And now, don't run into the middle of it. Let them come to you.
Fine, Sansu.
And now, back off just a bit. Let them come to you.
Oh,
and you know it's a wise choice to go at the weakest links because they deal damage too, but they're easier to kill. So don't go for the big club guy the first thing you do.
Have you ever seen a game designer?
We come to you.
I like your spirit. You take on a hard camp without any
interest. It's nice.
But it was stabby.
Yeah.
You should have stayed away.
Well,
I
don't have any defenses for him. I have to unlock those.
There's one defense can run away.
Yes, but
can you check out the
enough with the friendly banter.
Picked the wrong camp.
Yeah, go there, be a chicken.
Really? I'm gonna leave this camp.
Yeah, we cannot have the whole stream just you dying in one camp.
Fine. Pal.
Thanks for
Thanks,
that.
Buddy.
Okay, so let's. I guess we can show off the fast travel functionality. Or can I? Except I can't fast travel.
Yeah, you have to fight your way out. Get away from Stabby!
Yeah.
You can apparently fast travel even if you're a camp.
Run away!
Perhaps if you were going anywhere, perhaps you should pick up the club. Yeah. Too late. Stabby's here. Don't go for the Jerry can.
Yeah.
You have some water, right? So you can
drink
it if you're
playing stuff.
But you're running.
Some blood.
Oh, so fasty.
That's the perfect place for me to stand there. Waiting for them to drop.
No, because they drop on me.
Oh, great. You're gonna get him. You're gonna kill Stabby.
Yeah, he's not that tough. Not
so tough. Fire.
Now you can take it up.
I can take the knife. So Shiv is a really nice weapon. It unlocks these things called Shiv executions.
Yeah, you can see it there on the back.
So when I get a guy, I knock him out so he's dazed. I can use the Shiv to just instantly. This place. It's a bad place.
Of course, you can take out the Warcry with like a sniper shot or a shooting.
Shield Punisher X. But
maybe flee.
Sorry, maybe flee.
Hold to break. I don't think you can jump over.
They are really
initiative move.
Do it. Do it. Yes. Stab him in his face.
That's exactly what I know. Oh, you're angry. Finally.
Give in to your anger.
Great.
That's good.
Yes.
Stomp him in the back of his
But that's the good thing when it's a bit hard. It's really satisfying when you smash it.
And you know when you get him, when you kill that guy, eventually. Then you will pick up his weapon quickly.
Didn't I get them all? Did I actually make it? Yeah. Look.
And there he is.
Look. Listen now. He's
driving now.
I want to hear him.
No, he usually starts
begging for mercy. That little
exactly.
Creep.
He can beg. Right. See? Oh.
Nice. Emil, what have you been taking some kind of
anger pills?
Anger pills?
I like it.
So, while I'm doing this, you can talk a bit about the day-night cycle that you clearly see in the background.
Yes. So it's a really nice day-night cycle. Super nice sky, and also you get different types of enemies depending on if it's day or night. So you can talk a bit about Buzzard, maybe.
Yeah, we'll. If it's night, we will see them in the wasteland. These guys are kind of allergic to sunlight. They live underground in these tunnel systems that sort of stretch out like a hideous maze underneath the sands, and they drive around in these Buzzard vehicles. Vehicles which are almost like porcupines. They're covered in barbs and spikes protruding from every open area on them. And they hunt the surface dwellers, as they could probably call them. We don't know because they don't speak any language.
Finally!
And they're also called Red Eyes, and they're to be feared. They come out at night.
Yes.
Pretty cool.
But they don't come out in the daytime. They don't like the sun.
Yeah. So, as you saw, when I took out this camp, the threat of this region lowered. Meaning, I unlocked some new unlocks. I unlocked some new upgrades, so I'd say. What should we get? What do you think?
You should get a rammer. Or one of those grinders. Because you're so vulnerable on the side.
I feel like I should get some melee upgrades.
Yeah, maybe that's...
Yeah. Yeah.
If you're going to take on camps anyway.
Oh, I don't have enough scrap.
No.
And I couldn't do that. And can I do this?
Maybe
no.
New jacket?
No, I need to... I need to level up. Max, but I can install a new ram grill.
Yeah,
if I had scrap. Crap. So let's find some scrap.
128 in scrap.
Yeah,
I think that we've left a bunch of scrap laying around here. There usually is within the sort of sheltered areas, hidden scrap.
And there's a jar of cans.
Where is the entrance? Where did I come? No,
there it is. You see, there's some scrap in there.
Yeah, but
you didn't want that scrap.
Well, actually, I'm not sure how to get there. Looks like I should be able to come over, perhaps. No, never mind.
I think on the right side here, you had some scrap. Just laying. No, there's not.
So, I will need my card, so let's call for Chan. And let's go see Griffa.
Yeah.
Because I need some melee upgrades.
And
or I need some upgrades, period.
Griffa
yeah,
is the mysterious wanderer of the wasteland, with whom Max has a very special bond. It's really hard to tell if Griffo is real or not, or if it's just a figment of Max's imagination. Yeah,
he's kind of mad.
Max has been known to hallucinate.
Exactly.
Anyhow, he uses these Griffo tokens, as they're called, to upgrade his abilities and to grow as a man. To become more man-like, I'd say, because at the beginning of the game, Max has lost all of what we would call his humanity, and he's become a wild.
This is a cool thing. Sorry, just thinking.
Yeah.
This is a
anyway.
This is a first-person view of the car. I really like to drive it. It's not as easy to drive, but it's really cool. Start to see his markings.
So as you level up, Griffa appears.
Just walk slower. This is very scenic. You see, it's like a some kind of weird cult hanging out here.
You heard the sounds start changing.
Some creepy sounds going on. Who's over there?
Yeah, Griffa's. He's great.
This is some cool stuff right here. Let's talk to him.
I forgot what I was saying.
There you are. Chiefter of Sands. Letter of Blood. Remnants of a ruined past. You say you seek the Plains of Silence. But do you not wander them right now? The remains of your life. A perpetual flight. An escape from all that is human. Until one day... the Plains of Silence end, and you begin. You're the purpose in this life, my friend, although you fear to dream it. But pain will come, much more pain, before this purpose to you is made manifest. You know nothing of me. Look behind you, at June after June of drifting. Half-forgotten terrors. You flee them always. These past phantoms. And the madness that crawls inside. You've come to Griffith for a reason. Deep inside. Twisted around horrors from which you run. Lies your strength. Griffith can help. Help you venture down to where you daren't go yourself. And lay bare your true promise.
That's deep, man.
Yeah, that's what happens when you go to Griffa. But then, through inhaling that powder, he goes into this kind of menu. And
his
psychedelic menu. And in here he can lay bare his true promise.
Yes. So whatever you do in the game rewards you with the Griffa tokens, which kind of levels up Max, and he can spend those tokens at Griffa to unlock different abilities.
Maybe we should take that one.
Yeah, I feel like increasing my health is a good one. I also probably need my use of melee weapons.
And maybe a little
maybe
bit
my
bang.
Ability to remain in fury. What's that? Oh, actually, I should take that instead. So yeah, and let's get some scrap. Actually, I need the Amazon. There we go. So I had a lot of tokens because we haven't seen, we haven't been to Griffa before, and I had gathered some up.
Oh, he's hungover now.
Yeah, he's waking up. Where did Griffa go?
And where did all those mysterious markings go? It's like he was never here.
And those weird post effects, where did everything go?
But he's got like a pep in his step right now, you know?
Yes.
He's got a new sense of purpose. He feels a little bit better.
Yeah.
And there's his old buddy Chum, faithfully waiting.
What's going on here?
So...
you do not look murderous.
I need scrap. well with this.
There we have a...
RAM really increases the power of it.
Death comes to them who cross us.
You can hear the cowardly chum bucket shout out.
How much scrap do you need?
300, I think.
Oof. Need to find some better.
Whenever you've beaten an enemy, he gets very cocky.
Didn't you have like a scrap car somewhere? Or?
I don't think that one. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Are you saying something about my fighting skills? no, absolutely. We should switch out. So we're gonna.
It's gonna be harder now for me to do friendly banter.
You
want to
sit here?
Because. another guy's gonna come in now and help us do the controls.
Yeah, show us.
And he knows how to play this game.
I'm gonna hear this for some. Okay. I would if I had ammo.
Ah, you wasted all your ammo before, right?
Yeah, that's
so, but what are you... Oh. I'm gonna run up to him!
I pushed the wrong button.
If I run in a zigzag pattern, he won't be able to shoot me!
Yeah. Wait, let me just... So
that's the cancer fuse.
Oh, as you saw, this car has a really massive.
There you go.
That's
you
what
got
I
murdered.
I tried to talk while playing that. It's clearly not working out for me. So we're gonna invite a better player, and I can sit next to him and banter friendly.
Look forward to some friendly banter.
Do you want to sit there?
No, I can go here.
Okay.
So I hope that you watching this right now can see Lofan back
you.
Here as well.
Yeah.
And he's going to come up
really close.
Really close, like that. Yeah, that's nice.
No. All right, guys, I changed the graphic. My name is Kenny. I'm one of the QA engineers here at Avalanche Studios. And I'm going to take you through this camp. But I'm going to show you something that I like to do as opposed to playing the conventional design route.
He sounds so professional.
I don't
know.
Like, I do this in my spare time, man. My entire job is to play this game.
Alright.
So did we take out the sniper here? He did.
Yes.
Awesome. I am. Alright. So
I'm also not taking out snipers, that's like the one thing.
Oh, we still got the flame pipe to take care of. So we're gonna pull that down. That's the secret.
TCB. Take care of business.
One extra little bonus thing here. If you need some more scrap, here's a scrap billion, so we can take that back. We can take it back once we're done. Make sure to barge that guy. Hopefully, they won't be on top of it. These were the initial guys that were greeted as when we came into the camp. Now we've got a shotgun shell. So these three guys here. Oh, you changed the controls.
Yes.
I was going to shoot them all, but I forgot we switched the controls out.
Yeah, so that's worth mentioning. Some of the controls for like shooting and and aiming are, we have two sets, one that's more conventional to similar to what people are used to, where you shoot with the bumper, and one that has the controls where you shoot with a circle. That's the same. It's easier to use in conjunction with melee combat, which is why we've gone for that. But it's open for you to choose whichever you prefer.
Did you go through the optional objectives in the camps? Did you go through that?
No, we talked briefly.
And then I died. And then the subject changed.
It all turned into friendly banter, really.
Yeah. Well, we got some optional objectives in the camps, just for something extra for players to do. It includes breaking insignias, collecting all the scrap in the camp. And you get a little bonus if you 100% the camp. So there's a little incentive there to go for everything. Here's something I like to do, which is just this.
Yep.
Boom.
That's the
body parts everywhere.
Thunder stick, right?
Yeah. I'm gonna stab this guy again. Hopefully he'll blow up that barrel behind him. Nope. Yep,
yes.
There we go.
Nice.
Totally intended.
Oh yeah, absolutely. So roll over here. I'm gonna block that guy. Oh, damn it.
Now we hear the drumming of that.
Yeah, exactly.
This bastard war crier.
I mean, this is really a fun minigame in itself, trying to get as many people as possible in those fantastic explosions.
Yeah, definitely. It definitely sort of it lends itself to some emerging gameplay.
Can we hear him talk?
I think he might be. Oh no.
You're not supposed to kill him.
Yeah, he's just a lonely drummer boy now. He's got nobody to drum for. So
drum is last.
We'll leave him hanging up there, I think. Or you know what?
Nah.
Let's do that. Boom. All right. So we actually need one of these things one more time, because the door that we're gonna blow through is protected. So we're gonna have to go through and blow this up. That was the wrong button. So I'm going to take one more of these just for a bit of fun, or more fun.
As you may see, they endlessly spawn.
Yes.
Because why not?
So. Why would we limit the player, you know, to allow them to blow things up? You know, it's not how we work here. So I'm going to drop that. I'm going to take this guy quickly. And because we killed him, we've got Fury Mode, which makes us a little bit more powerful.
That's when he broke his spine.
Yes, he can't walk anymore.
I want to jump in here and mention that this is a slightly easier camp.
No.
Than the one I tried.
No, I can confirm it is an easier camp.
Yes, he's QA, so he knows.
Yeah,
he knows.
And I put this.
It says explosion required.
It does.
Does that mean that you could explode that from up here with the thunder stick?
Exactly. Now, there's a fuel dispenser right there, so ordinarily you can go down there, you can drop a fuel can right there. But I like to do this instead. Oh, shit.
Oh.
Do you like to jump into the oil?
Okay,
yeah, I switched out the controls.
Yeah, that's going to get me every single time. You know what? I think I might change.
Can
them.
You switch it back?
Yeah,
you
can
I'm going to switch these back. Where are we? Controllers.
Button
maps.
Button maps,
yeah.
So switch to default.
There we go. So as you can switch back to the controller. Max is limping a little bit after my fantastic tumble. So we're going to do that and blow up the camp.
Like a pro.
But that is an easier camp. Like, much easier. So.
But solid effort.
Okay.
Let's not take away from your skills.
It's the skills I've honed over quite a long time. So,
drink some water, maybe?
Yeah, actually, I'm pretty low on health. So what we're gonna do now is
take the scrap lines.
Absolutely.
Or are you gonna 100% the camp?
No, we won't do that. We're not gonna reveal everything, you know, to this stream. We gotta save some secrets. Okay, so we're gonna take the scrap lines back because we need the scrap boost. What we could actually do as well is we could do a side mission.
Oh yeah.
Could do that.
Yeah, that sounds like cool. I think I actually. We got the briefing of the bullet farm guy.
Oh, excellent. Because that's exactly the one I wanted to do.
You have some scrap in there.
That's not worth it.
Okay,
I mean, I've got like a
So these guys,
those guys aren't enemies now.
Those aren't enemies. When you complete camps, your like friendlies, your stronghold guys, they move in, and they take over the camp, and they start
turning it into their own camp.
And then
bringing scrap over to their strongholds and building them up also.
Yeah, so you get a constant income of scrap for every camp you take on.
You may have seen when we've entered, you can drive any enemy vehicle in the game. As long as it's got four wheels and an engine, we can drive it.
You can drive it if it has three wheels.
Oh, even if it's got three wheels, yeah. I mean, you might spin around in circles, but you can still drive it.
Yeah.
And what you can do, if it's a vehicle that belongs to the Scrotus faction, like this Scrapulus, you saw the message, I'm undetected by the Scrotus faction. That means if I drive up to a camp, potentially they will open their doors for me. And I can just drive right in there without even alerting the sniper guards.
Until you get out of the car.
Until I get out of the car, and then they go crazy. And they want to kill me.
Upgrade! So you have so much
scrap level.
Yes, we can definitely upgrade. What was your upgrade?
How much did you get for... Oh,
we got 500 for the scrap
levels. That's really nice.
So
that's a lot of moolah.
Well, I don't think you can upgrade max. Because you need a new level.
Yeah.
But you should have a lot of garage upgrades.
Awesome. Okay. It looks like we've got some... Oh, actually, what we can do...
Go for the...
We can now grind some tires.
Oh, yes.
Grind some rims.
Spiky.
Yeah.
So Ripperonis.
You don't really just ram in this game. We can also destroy opponents' tires by driving, grinding right up against them. And we can also shield ourselves from borders.
So you mean you can grind people like Ben-Hur?
Sure. Sorry,
that's
for
that
1%
of the
that's a reference.
The
I don't get. I'm really sorry.
Oh, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, we know, but we're old.
But we're real old, man.
We're not.
Yeah, I don't know either.
All right.
I've not seen Ben.
Oops. So part of this mission, in order to proceed with it, we also have to change the car body of the Magnum Opus. All the bodies can be found out in the wasteland, somewhere, the locations. There's always a car body to be found.
So there are I think five different car bodies. At the start of the game, when you actually build the Magnum Opus, so you get to choose one of them. So you can choose whichever you want, whichever you prefer, and the rest you can then find spread out in the wasteland.
So you can switch to all.
It basically means the choice you make at the start of the game isn't a permanent one, and it means that you can control. Oops. Oh, it's that guy. It means you can control how your car really wants, or how it really works. I don't really have time to just deal with it.
Do you have any shotgun ammo?
I do.
I just never had shotgun ammo.
I'm getting lucky with the drops.
Yeah,
that's all I'm saying. RNGesus has been kind to me.
Luck and skill go hand in hand.
Uh oh. Oh, you see, doing that finisher is a bit of a risk, because these guys can punch you out of it.
That's what happens to me all the time.
Nice.
There we go. Looks like there's a roadkill camp here.
Yeah.
More ammo. That's good. Although, to be fair, you did upgrade. Did you upgrade the ammo for me?
No.
No?
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Maybe it was upgraded.
You may have, actually. Yeah, so you can see.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
You
exactly.
Did.
So,
that's why I'm getting ammo.
So, precisely.
Yeah.
So, I upgraded your ability to find ammo. That's
that's why things are going so well for you right now.
Yeah. That's
so,
that's
you should
exciting.
Thank me.
Yes, I will. Oh, it looks like we still need some scrap. But we can't be that far off. 150.
We'll find what we need.
At this early stage of the game, as you can see, Max only has his pipe gun, like a very, very crude, homemade kind of scrap shotgun. And it's a single barrel one. So, but there will be upgrades.
Yes.
Believe you me, there will be upgrades.
So there's one thing up here. Not all the camps have just scrap and ammo in them. Some of them will include project parts. So, this will help you fortify a stronghold leader's stronghold.
Yeah, so when we started out the stream and you saw in Jeets the different projects that you can complete, these are the kind of parts that build those. And if you, I mean, we mentioned there's five car bodies, and all of you who love pre-orders, you know, everyone loves them. You can, if you pre-order, you get a sixth car body.
Okay, so this is actually a very strong count. Oh, fire hand already. I'm gonna ignore that one. I will die very easily in that camp right now.
This hideout. What can you tell me about it?
It's a convoy. That's not good.
Is that a convoy or some?
It's a convoy.
You better for me. Yeah, this guy's following.
Hi, friend. Oh, I've got a shotgun. Yeah, I have a shotgun.
Yeah, you have. That's
okay. He's one of the guys just making sure I stay away from the convoy. And he did his job.
So now you're going for the side mission?
Yep, that's right.
Yeah, so to recall what that was about, he has heard that there's a gang of slavers nearby that has actually a guy
from
a bullet farm. Cook black powder. So he wants you to retrieve that guy from the slavers. And this is their nasty lair that you've found.
Now, slavers in this world, they don't serve the same purpose as slavers would any other. They're called thrall rustlers. There's only a small portion of people in the wasteland that are valuable enough to hold as slaves, and that's people who have a special kind of knowledge. Because, essentially, manpower is everywhere, and everybody wants to be safe. I mean, everybody wants to be safe, because if you're just walking around in the wasteland, you'll starve to death or get killed. So if you find some of the few hubs that even remotely resembles civilization, if you work, you will at least get fed, and somebody might protect you. And okay, they will beat you randomly, and sometimes you'll suffer, and you know, but it's much better than dying in the wasteland anyway. So the whole concept of slaves is not really, it's not really something that works anymore. So thrall rustlers, they specialize in finding people with special skills, like our guy right here from the bullet farm.
He's dead. Yeah, he's,
so these guys, see there's a bear trap there? That's one of my favorite things. That's one of my favorite things to do in the game. If you can bait an enemy to running through a bear trap,
yeah,
they just die instantly.
Did his leg come off?
No, unfortunately.
Looked like it.
I don't think he quite ran into it properly.
It did come off, but it just miraculously landed.
Yeah. It's
one of the many mysteries of the wasteland.
Ah, health is
full health. So that's a Dinky D can. Another one of the food sources that you have.
Yep.
Obviously a nod to one of the Mad Max movies. If you know which one.
You will get a prize when you go to heaven.
Valhalla.
Valhalla, of course.
Serve the machine gun in Valhalla.
Okay, so I think we're getting close to their main lair where they're keeping our shotgun ammo cook. Let's try and run through here. There we are. So there's a much tougher enemy guarding him.
Yeah, so he's a road buckler, and he has a shield, and he uses it both to ram you, but also to shield himself from incoming damage.
Uh-oh. Oh, this guy's blocking my shots. Oh, I was trying to get him to hit his friend there, but...
So you can get through the shield guy in some ways. One is obviously evade him, go around him, hit him in the back where he's less defended. You can, with certain weaponry, I believe, and abilities, you can actually shatter this field, obviously with the shotgun as well. And you can do the barge move that Kenny did to knock him off his feet or attack his body. Then you can deal with Kenny, kick his ass.
And he's gone.
He literally kicked his ass.
Yeah,
he did. He stomped him right above his buttocks.
So yeah, I managed to. You can evade the buckler, you can shoot the shield as well.
He grabbed that thing out of his ass.
You have no.
Yeah, unfortunately, I had no shotgun ammo, so I had to change my tactics in taking down that enemy. And they have unblockable attacks, like the charge, you can't block that. And they have strong attacks as well, you can't block them. So, this little guy here, this is the guy we're looking for.
I heard tell there's one who knows how to cook powder here.
And if I was that one?
I'd get you out of here. Are you him or not?
Blast camp. Yes. Yes, I am. Seeing as you killed those two who fed me. They call me Blastcap. Hail from the Bullet Farm.
Okay. So, thankfully we've purchased the upgrade, which allows us to break him open. Or break his cage open, rather. We need him alive.
Yeah, so you got the Jimmy Bar, which is a tool. And with it you can
get yourself the Jade's
break
lighthouse.
Certain locks in the wasteland. Some tied to like missions. Some are just loot stashes. Some open up new areas that have secrets.
So even though we found like a project part out in the wasteland, but some projects do require some site missions to be completed as well. So we're looking at, we need 40 more scrap. I think there's some scrap through here as well. Somewhere down here. So, there's a bit of scrap.
A secret stash.
Yeah, there's little cubby holes, tunnels, things like that, always off to the side, inside camps and inside loot locations. And they usually hide something good.
Yeah, you're rewarded for snooping around.
I see it's still nice and dark. So, let's think, what should we do? We could do a death run.
Yeah, we should do a death run, definitely. Need to show that.
So, we can go, let's see.
You got the one
fast
down
travel
there.
Here. Yeah, should we go to this one?
Yeah.
He's a nasty guy.
Yeah, he's one of your arch enemies, I would say. Oh. Called Stankum.
Behold! Hey, actually, the camps that we just completed actually gave us some scrap over time. When you complete a camp, you get 20 scrap, and you're rewarded that every, I think, I can't remember how long it is, but periodically, you get some scrap.
There's no time in the wasteland.
Yeah, there's no time in the wasteland. It's timeless. But it's actually allowed us, it's actually given us the 40 scrap that we need to upgrade. Oh, crap. Well, there goes that challenge.
Oh, is it a...
It's a
drop kicker?
No. I'm not sure what it is actually.
It is a drop kicker. It is a drop kicker! I love that car. You have to steal it.
I have to steal the car?
Yeah.
Alright, so. Steal his door. And then hopefully tear him out of the car. Oh yeah, he's dropped some lines.
Ooh, some ice. Nice driving.
There's one benefit of using the side ram. You can use it to very quickly adjust your. Adjust your trajectory. Oops. Can you find the death here? Alright, you know what? We'll let him get away. I think. I'm sorry, Emil. I'm sorry.
Ah, that's my favorite car.
Okay.
Oh well.
So who's this guy?
Because you can take that car and you can use those mines yourself. Okay. That's what it's for.
Lo! Here comes a wanderer. I, Crow Dazzle, welcome you to the Circle of Light. To the circle of the brave, the skilled, and the quick. You've come very far.
How are we doing for time?
And with a great hunger.
5 minutes.
2 minutes left. Excellent, we've got plenty of time to show off some cool stuff.
Are you one who seeks to win a name for himself? Or who wishes to bind to the heart of his machine?
Do you design this guy?
Are you both?
What are you saying?
Some of it. No, it was Yuka.
Racing sun is a many splendid
the back
thing.
There.
There are
some
who
some
come
parts.
To Crow Dazzle
I think
for the glory
of almost every
to beat the baddest the wasteland
all the feathers like,
and have their names
like ruffle
out in
thing.
Fireside
yeah.
Tales
very, very polished feathers.
For ages to come. Others are on the path of the spirit. They seek the death run.
And obviously part of this character's grotesque flair.
To their machines.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
What's your wish here?
Yeah, he's like a crow. He's an interesting guy.
Yeah, so death runs. Tell us the backstory of death runs. Odd.
Well, death runs are designed as a part of Wasteland lore, part of Wasteland mythology, for a an aspiring road warrior fighter to bind his soul with the soul of a vehicle. And if you succeed, then you and that vehicle will have a very special bond.
This is accomplished by strapping an explosive and then racing to finish it.
Yes, exactly. It's just really something that you have to experience, I would say. Because it's a spiritual endeavor.
This particular car, because of the very heavy ramming grill on it, it's very front heavy, which makes it a little bit difficult to control the corners. Because each car handles differently in the game. And during this particular death run, I have to smash through some barrels. There are different types of death runs. This is just one of them. And you get an option of vehicles, or you can do it in a magma opus. Whenever you customize. There you can see, I am miles ahead of them. So
just too good at this game. Yeah.
Assuming my hubris doesn't get the better of me, then. We should win this.
Yeah, and your bomb will not be a problem. So yep. Your soul will not be sent off to Valhalla after all.
Exactly.
Isn't that not the same as losing?
It is for a Viking, I think, isn't it?
Well, I mean, if you lose gloriously, it's not considered a loss. It's just it's a brave effort.
That's right.
And we'll get rewarded for it.
You can see that there's a flare there indicating the finish line. But if we were to go there early, then we'd lose because we have to hit all the barrels, we have to, all the checkpoints. So, we have to follow the red path, smash the button, and it looks like we're on the home straight.
But still, I mean, your driving is quite skilled, but still, you only got 25. I mean, if you would have just turned one corner,
there you go.
You know.
And obviously, there's a legendary time that you can go for that gives you some extra rewards.
Yeah, but clearly you didn't get that, Kenny.
No, I
didn't.
No, I got it.
He got it.
No, you gotta have some faith.
So much for friendly banter.
It's impossible with this guy. It's too good.
I know. That's my job to play this game.
Yeah, never play with him.
Yeah, that's right. You have the best job in the world. You just sit around playing games.
Yeah, that's what everybody thinks.
Yeah.
Oh, that was too good for the game.
We're lucky that came down.
We hear that there's maybe some stuttering at some people, but that's stream issues because we are streaming in 30 FPS and it is very smoothly running.
But the game naturally plays at 30 frames a second without any problem, but our stream setup might not be the best displaying that. So sorry if you're having some issues, but trust us, the game runs at 30 frames a second.
It's a good thing, cooking powder. I eat well, and I don't try.
This is the project that I unlocked by saving Blastcap's life.
You can see there, Blastcap has been working around explosives his entire life, so he does only have one hand. But
he's no less skilled.
He's really skilled because he's got the cooking recipes up in his head. That's in the brain bag is where it happens for a cook like him.
I can come back to the stronghold at any time to get my ammo refilled. However, there is a cooldown, so I can't just go there repeatedly.
We want to hear what Pete has to say?
Yeah, he has another side mission. Let's go see what he's got. We'll see what's if he's got anything to update on even. I can't even speak.
We know how to cook that powder, but we don't have the makings. We got coal, but sulfur? You gotta recon a source for that. And then something that we can't mine. Salty peat. Gotta farm that. Frozen.
That's true.
Pissing on corpses. You gotta find sulfur and peat.
No. I bring you the prisoner. You get me ammo. That's the deal.
Take these! It's all I got. You need more, you get me more sulfur and peat.
Okay, so maybe not all the ammo in the world from just rescue that one person.
I knew it wasn't going to work out.
I'll mark anything I find.
Get into business with those kinds of guys.
Nah, they're pretty shady. So what we can do, we gain the necessary scrap to finally upgrade Dagnopus to what we call the Jack. So there we've changed the car body. You can see we can rotate the camera around and you can look at it from any angle. It looks like... Do we have enough scrap? We do have enough scrap. So we have to change the exhaust. Unfortunately, this particular vehicle requires a little less weight on it to make it a bit more nimble. So we have to remove our upgrades if we want to build this particular model of vehicle.
We have all the makings, all the pieces.
And as mentioned, it's not always the best to just go max out on every single thing, because more stuff means more weight, means worse handling, etc. So it's really no perfect car other than what type of car you prefer to play yourself. So a fast little car, or a heavy duty tank type of car, or offensive like ramming car. So it's. We pretty much expect everyone to have like a different magnum opus.
Once you've bought those things, you can always go back.
Yeah, you can just tinker around. And
you don't have to
anyway,
be strong, but you can still do it.
Yeah.
Wherever. Shooter! I love seeing the camp lights at night. They really like stand out. And the color palette is completely gone. When we start, completely changed. We started the stream, it was daytime, everything was orange and sandy, and slowly transitioned to a nice cool and very peaceful blue.
It's based where the buzzers come out. Good.
Yes, it's a very deceiving piece.
Yeah. Enjoy it while it lasts.
I shall. Yeah, I'm going to enjoy it so much I'm going to go in first person mode. As quick as I can, although I can't control it, apparently.
Watch your back, Saint. He's ruthless.
So we're making our way to another stronghold, where in this territory a different person rules.
They say he foretells the rising of the seas again.
What can you offer?
Heavy plates of steel are.
You see this stronghold over there in the distance? It's actually a stranded old ship.
Like
a tanker.
Sorry.
His name is Gatgash.
Here it is ahead.
And On can tell you all about him. Or some things about him.
Well, Gatgash settled down in this old shipwreck, and the people he had gathered around him, his tribe, if you will, he has convinced them that the waters are coming back to these shores and that they need to make the ship seaworthy again for them to be able to sail away to whatever promised land he has promised them, and it has become a religion to these people, and it's something for them to cling to in these times of need, especially now that the warlord Scrovis is tightening his noose around the area. But I let the sea speak for itself.
It's a trap. Have to say, sorry.
I was hoping to say, oh my god, they killed Kenny, but you never died.
I haven't died yet.
Only a time to kill.
I preempted that.
That's why you're such a good QA. You never want to hear that line again.
It is! It's the little count of the carburetor. Oh, who could forget that whimpering? And the devious suckling face.
Oh, dead a dozen times if you do, boy. We've come to deal.
Nothing else. I got gas.
So pitch me, little man.
He also has a pretty majestic beard. Max needs to grow a little bit longer, I think.
Yeah.
You sent to me by the angel combustion herself.
Incidentally, he looks exactly like our technical art director.
Very, very similar.
He does, yeah.
A bit older, but he's actually based on him. So.
Yeah. Oh. You, this guy you mean, right?
Yeah.
I have nothing left.
No.
This car needs healing. She does. And strengthening. Yes.
Even Chum has a little bit of scruff for a beard. So. Sharp razors and clean razors are hard to come by in the wasteland.
Yeah.
Hands of a Blackfinger. Yes.
This is Simona. That made this guy.
Yeah, of course. Sorry.
Really nice.
You'll have one chance for me.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, B.
That was gut gash. It's about as bitter and salty as the sea he worships.
He says that he wants a black finger on a leash because he doesn't want any of his perversions on his ship. Chumbuck is known to have his sway with mechanical objects every now and then.
Whoa. There's a bit of a rave going on here. Alright, so we're going to go and upgrade, or find the last piece to upgrade and finish the Magnum Opus. Or finish this version of the Magnum Opus that we're making.
Well then, Moya.
Maybe we should use the flashlight.
Yeah, it's a little bit dark in here, isn't it? There we go. As you can see, it's very it's old and rusty.
And the same way here, like with Jeets, as you come here the first time, it's really a rundown place. They're on their last... they're really pressured by Scrotus and his war boys, but as you start working for them, lowering the threat in the region, you will also see the strongholds coming to life in interesting ways, and people coming there, more people living there.
So close. Luckily there's some scrap here as well. Alright, and we can finally install that last upgrade.
The armor. So every stronghold leader has kind of a specialty when it comes to cars. So Gakash is very good at armors, ramming grills. Jeet is all about the weaponry. Some other people that you meet later in the game are good at like wheels and engines. So they all have their kind of specialties.
It's almost like it's designed that way.
It's very it's just very natural.
Yeah. Sometimes things just work out.
And ready for anything?
It won't be complete until we get the V8 from Gastown.
Indeed, yeah. And maybe not even that.
Yeah, well, actually.
10 minutes.
Ten minutes.
10 minutes. What's the awesomest thing we can do in 10 minutes?
Well, I was gonna say, unfortunately, the next story mission is locked, and we have to fulfill the requirements for the mission. We've already reached the required rank, but we have to dismantle a camp. So,
That can be pretty spectacular.
Yeah,
pretty difficult also sometimes.
Yeah, I mean sometimes if you choose the wrong one, but I'm sure Kenny won't choose the wrong one.
I'm actually wondering which one to choose. There's several dotted about in every region.
I think you should choose the one that has the most explosions.
Let's see. Which one has the most explosions?
You dare go for a top dog?
I was thinking about it. There's no explosions, but...
But
yeah,
no, top dog is cool
tough.
Because then you get to see that perverted top dog and maybe kill him. And,
yeah.
And
I know exactly the one to go for. It's somewhere around here. And although we played the game mainly in this region over here, but now we're in this one, and there's still a whole other half of the world to go through.
Holy macaroni!
So, yeah, we're barely through this thing. We've been playing it for almost 2 hours. Oh,
Never mind those
guys.
Should
I give them water?
No. No.
Nah, okay. Screw
those guys want water, man. They can look for water elsewhere.
So, occasionally you come across wanderers in the wasteland, like regular people trying to survive and not succeeding very well. And you can, in fact, stay and help them out, give them water, and sometimes they can reveal certain locations in the world that you can't find out about any other way. But other times they just don't give you anything. So it's
except for that
good Samaritan
feelings.
Yeah. Makes you feel kind for once in this very, very harsh world.
And you can accidentally run them over.
You can, which I almost did.
And you can intentionally run them over.
Yeah. You can get out of the car and kill them as well.
But that would be very...
Oops. This is a bad place to meet these guys.
Look, you did
it, bro. I escaped. I ran out there. I don't think I can actually shoot anything on them because they've got armor.
Catching up.
Oh, missed. Yeah, the drop kicker, he wants to try and get in front of me.
A drop kicker? Drop kicker!
I can sight ram into these guys. Didn't have a lot of power there.
You should be able to pull them up. Try to lure him into the mines.
Pull my other windscreen. Or what's left of the windscreen. Taking all the armor off that car, I can go back later and destroy that for scrap, but this guy is annoying.
Do you have any shotgun?
I do. I don't know if I... can I target it? Target the ammo, the armor. Can I target the explosive in the back? I can.
Yeah.
There it goes.
No, you won't get to drive it.
Yeah, I've kind of ruined the chance there to really drive that vehicle.
Your futile quest for the drop kicker has cost us 2 minutes.
But it is pretty
fun. Here, this camp is it's very well fortified. So this could be a little bit tough. This could be the camp where I do die.
And then we get to say it, right?
You can. You're allowed to say, oh my god, you killed Kenny. Okay. Got one more shot. We got two spare. We're going to sneak a little bit closer just so we can get a cleaner shot. Hopefully without alerting the camp. And now we've taken out the snipers. They shouldn't alert our presence. Until I get really close. Until I cause an explosion, possibly. Because they're going to wonder what the hell happened there.
So this is one way to approach camp. Another way is like you can just run into it and hope for the best. That works as well.
Sometimes.
Eventually.
Almost drove him right into that Molotov. This guy's on a platform. Oh no, he's not. Oh, I missed him. He was right in front of me, and I missed. There we go. So all we have to do now is ram into the camp.
Not strong enough.
So, ramming grills, when you upgrade them, they will not only do more damage to cars and stuff, but also when you ram into stuff like gates, they
scarecrows,
will do
gates.
More
damage. Yeah.
I'll show you. There's one little trick I like to do with this camp. Oh, if I can actually get rid of these guys safely. Oh, don't hit me. I'm going for the flashy moves.
Yeah, Kenny. when they're signaling that they're gonna hit you in the back of the head with a spiked baseball bat.
Yeah.
Give him a rest. It's harder than.
There we go.
Dude, I'm hired to do friendly banter. And that's what I'm gonna do.
I missed at least two of those attacks. So I just drop kicked thin air right there. It was too far away from me. Oh,
so close.
Damn it!
I was gonna suplex him. I'll just kick him in the face instead.
Running well.
Yeah, okay. This could be the end. Oh, I have to be really careful.
Okay. Nice!
Now, you can replenish some health if you can kill. If you can actually kill anyone in fear mode, you will get a little bit of health back. Oops. Survive. There we go. But I've
you was born to kill.
What a slaughter. Yep. Nice work.
And hey, we got
you burned every drop, buddy.
That's a victory sip. That's what that is.
Yeah. You know what you can get now? You can get longer beard.
Oh, I can?
What every man strives for.
Did I level up? Ooh, let's see.
Yeah, get him a longer beard.
Yeah, let's
take him away from
beard.
That Stockholm look.
Look at that. Look at that.
Look at that beard.
And then you have the bare-chested version of him.
Yeah.
Strip him down.
If you want to be risky, I mean, if you're a speedrunner or something like that, and you want to go for like a no defense, no upgrades version, you can go like this.
Yes,
that's cool. I mean, that's masculine, tough.
Yes. I don't have scrap. But this is what he would look like if we did have scrap.
Oh, that's pretty badass.
Looks familiar somehow.
It's a little classic.
Yeah,
classic look. We'll go back to this. Because, no we won't. Yes we will. So we'll go back to that because I need my flashlight and the tiny bit of defense that thing gives me.
Got 4 minutes.
4 minutes? Okay, I better hurry then.
Not faster.
Alright. So, we've only got 4 minutes. You can see there's a crane there. That's one of those war criers again. What I like to do is I like to aim over this. Whoops.
Do it.
Oh. Or fire eliminated.
you beat the game.
Masterful.
That's a nice little trick shot.
How many times have you played this camp?
Oh, I don't know. A million. This is one of my personal favorite camps. So. Especially like the fact I have to climb the towers, essentially. There's a lot of verticality in this camp. So,
is it Steph that did this camp?
I think it was Steph, yeah. Actually, yeah.
Nice.
So we got some guys down here trying to start a fight. And that shiv I just picked up in this guy's head.
Oh. I like that he slid his stuff and then...
Yeah.
Like,
overdo
it. Slight overkill, yeah. Oh, I'm getting caught. My timing is off. There we go.
Nice.
Can I go flashy? Yeah. Oh, it's too far away. Now I look like an idiot. Suplex. Too far away.
Ouch. You broke his neck.
Dropped him right in his head.
He's still... Was he dead there?
Yep, he was dead. That's slow motion. It's kind of like a finisher.
Yeah, you die from that usually when you break
yeah,
somebody's...
Yeah, but he had like this...
He has an arch.
Like he had his head still attached to his body. Yeah, you don't have to remove it.
That was so.
You see there, I got the allied camp scrap again.
How can you be certain if it's not a gimmick? That's my motto.
That's a very, very true motto.
So we have to make our way to the top of the tower to face the top dog. Who's a much tougher enemy than anything we've faced so far in the demo. So
you got 1.5 minutes to beat him.
We got 1.5 minutes.
Piece of cake.
You can do it.
I'll try. There's
take
only
the shiv.
Whoa.
Oh,
good one. Good one. Fast, expedient.
Yep. Can I pick it up? Oh,
yeah.
I'm
kill that fucking guy.
On camera. And let's go.
You
stabbed him through his brain.
Well, right now we can only have one shiv, but that's one of the things you can upgrade. Your shiv holster, along with like how much ammo you can carry, different stuff.
Nah, I think we've only got a minute left. I'm going to have to make this fight very quick.
I think that you can, too.
I don't know, the top dogs are extremely tough, so...
Yeah, but you can...
No! You don't come here! Not here!
So if you beat this guy, you get the silver.
Yes.
Oh, chrome for vehicle. Chrome it up.
You don't have So this particular top dog, each one has a weakness of some shape or form. This one doesn't like fire, so what we're going to do is we're going to try and bait him into the fire, and then we're just going to hit him with some weapons, some stronger weapons.
And obviously he installed the flamethrowers as kind of a therapy, exposure therapy.
Well,
to deal with his fear of fire.
He's burning!
Well, I'm not trapped in here with him. He's trapped in here with me. Oh, I'm gonna get out of the corner a little bit. Because I can effectively strike him. When you can, you can dodge his attacks, and when he's not looking, bam. And you can also use the shifts on these guys as well.
Still in the anus.
But it's not a one-shot kill as it is with other guys, because these guys are tougher.
Yep.
Just keeps him going.
So he's still sticking out of his neck.
Yeah.
So
just gets him.
Oh, we broke the weapon. Ouch. Okay, so he's only got a little bit of health left.
Ow!
And we strike. Bam. Oh. We should only take one or two more hits left. And smack him again.
I think we'll make this look easier than it really is.
I can tell you, this is not easy at all.
Yep. Come on, a little bit more. Oh, I broke that weapon as well. There's only got a little bit of health left, so. There we go.
Triumph!
So the skull caved in and the camp complete.
Well done. Great work.
Did I run over?